To my channel. My name is Yetunde Adeyemi, but you can also call me Mrs. O. I know it's been a while I made any video because I've not had any video on this YouTube channel since 2017. But I apologize because last year I got married and I had a baby, so I had to take a break from making the videos. So, but I hope and pray that henceforth we'll be back to making you videos, hopefully weekly. So today I just want to talk about a flounce. When we say a flounce is like a flare, all these things they add on the body. When I finish cutting it, you probably understand what a flounce means. They add it's like a flare that can be added to the dress to distract maybe your tummy area. You put it at the side, you put it on the sleeve, different parts of where you're putting it. So when you say you want to cut a flounce, some people call it some other things, but I know it has a flounce. When we say what do we need for today, we are just going to use our tape roll. I need my scissors, I need my chalk, and I just need my French gloves. I might not be using them actually, but most times when we cut, it's like things we use for our classes. And then a ruler. I need this short ruler, should be enough for me, but depending on what you're cutting, you might not use a short ruler. So like I said, we want to cut a flounce. So the first thing you need to do when you're making a flounce is that you get a four corner paper. So let's pay attention to what you're doing. A 15 inches space, 15 by 15. So I mark my 15 inches, a 15 by 15. Now this space is dependent on the number, how large your flounce is. Flounce can be very wide, but for this class I'll just be doing a simple flounce. Let's see what you can do. So I'm doing a 15 by 15. You can have a larger number, you can actually even use the old paper depending on what you want to do. So if I do my 15 by 15 all through for the flounce, whatever you're using for your paper, mark your box. So this is a full box. Now this is a square box. It can be fabric, it can be your paper, you can just do straight on your fabric. So once I have that, you need to get the middle of your box. So this is 7.5, that is the middle, and then you also have 7.5. So this is the middle of our paper, which is the starting point. So once you have the middle of the paper, you have your box. The first thing is get like a 1 inch or a 2 inch circle around that dot. So for today, I'll just be doing a 1 inch, a 1 inch or 2 inch. You need that circle to get a good result. You must have a 1 inch circle all around. So just get our one inch from the center. You can do a 2 inches if you have a large fabric, but for today I'll just be, so you get a circle. So I have my one inch circle. So once you get your circle, the next thing is you get the flounce. So flounce, you just have to start from anyway, just get your circle out. Then how wide do you want your flounces? Most flounces are always between, let's say, 3, 4, 5, 6, depending on what you are. Stay on it. No, dependent on what you have. So let's say I'm going to agree that I need a 2 inches flounce plus 1 inch sewing allowance. So if I need my 2 inches, I'll definitely be sewing it. So I'll be doing a 3 inches flounce now. So that means that's 3 inches you need to make it meet your starting point. But after that starting point, you start to do your 3 inches. You do your 3 inches, you just keep moving around in 3 inches from your 1 inch circle. From your 1 inch circle, you do your 3 inches, and then you keep moving. From your 1 inch, you do your 3 inches. Now, once we get to the point where we started, we're going to now continue on that line. 3 inches. You see where I'm continuing for? You continue on that line. 3 inches. 3 inches. 3 inches. Now, your flounce can be wider than this. Like I said, I'm just assuming this is a 2 inch flounce plus 1 inch sewing allowance. So whatever flounce you have to add your sewing allowance. So I'm just doing it 3 inches all around nicely. 3 inches after my circles, after each circle. Now, like I said, you can get this with a flare, but a flare will not fall well like this system, and this saves you fabric. So I'm just going to link my 3 inches all the way. Now this is how wide you want your flounce to be. It can be wider than this. So I have my 3 inches, I connect them. Now note that I stopped here. Now how you want to end your flounce is dependent on what you want. You can just do a sharp edge and bring it back, or you can keep coming down to meet Okay, that's too sharp. Let's see, keep coming down gradually to meet the former line. You can just do a sharp edge. Now, once you have your 3 inches in terms of how wide you want it to be, now the next thing you consider is the length. That is, what's the length of flounce you need? That's depending on where you're going to add it. So I'm just going to cut this out and then probably explain it on my own body. So now you will, now if you, whatever you want, you will measure what you have. You're going to measure. Now let's agree that I need probably a 40 inches flounce. I'm measuring what I have on this line. So the circle is the length of our flounce. So I have 20 already. So I'm just measuring, just measure round. So like I said, let's say we need a 40. This is already more than 40, which is fine, but I'll just be cutting everything. So the flounce you need is, the length is just, you just keep marking, just keep drawing. If this length, if what you have now, I think on 40 was, let me just finish up, 40 was here. Let's see what you have in total. We have 60. This is 60 plus that's like an extra 15. This is a 75. If what you need is more than a 75, then definitely you need to get a larger space. Then you keep going, just keep your round, keep your round till you get, stay on this spot, till you get what you need. So once you do that, let me just cut. So I'm just going to cut out my box first. You can do this on a paper, you can, but I do it directly on a fabric, but because I'm probably not needing any of that, that's why I'm not using a fabric direct. So once you have this, then we cut our flounce originally. Now you can panel, you can pencil your flounce back, or you can actually have a sharp edge. So cut your 3 inches, just keep cutting, cut on your line or cut after your line depending on how you cut, but for probably fresh people in the game, cut after the line. You're not sure of what your measurement is, to be on the safe side. So keep going, keep going, keep going. Please watch what you are doing. This is a paper. Your fabric cut exactly on the line, so you can have and let your round be round. So that already eaten into the circle. So be careful. Let me take my time a little. So keep going in that circle. In that circle. You can just use your scissors easily. Don't cut in too deep. So now this is a paper. The beautiful thing about using a paper is because once you're on your fabric, you can alter your mistakes if you want to place it on fabric. But I think for your flounce, it is easier to just cut it direct on your fabric. So we get to the finishing line, and then we cut out, and then we cut out our circle. Now this circle, we are not using it, it's just to start our flounce. Like I said, 1 or 2 inches circle is fine depending on the size of your fabric. Okay, so we have our flounce. I think right now you should already understand what I'm doing. Come back. So this is a flounce. It's like a flare. But if you notice this one, this is quite fuller than a flare. Now where do they use the flounce? You can have it at the side of the dress. Imagine this at the side of my dress. You can have it like as a peplum, but it's fuller than cutting a flip. You can have it as a peplum, and then this one will go to the side of your dress. You can have something like this. We have people using it to do, you know, some circles on the body, and do something like this. Okay, keep coming, you know, turn it like that, do that, and come to the side. Then I've seen cases of people using the flounce around the sleeve. You can have it around the sleeve like that on your sleeve. So there are different things you can use the flounce for, like you should already understand. But this is obviously, it saves you a lot of fabric than using a flare, and then it also costs more than a flare. So now this is a 3 inches, you can do a larger size. Like I said, this is a sharp edge. If you don't want a sharp edge, probably where you want it to end, you can also have like you can just have this depending on where you want it. If you want it to end that way, you have it that way. If you want it to come back in the panel, do it. But that beginning where you start from, you have no choice but to have a paneled edge. If you now don't want this, you can also still cut along the line and start from there. You can have it, if you want this to be the beginning, then let this be the beginning. So you can actually start like this. So So you have people doing it on, I just put it in the middle of your dress. So you know all these styles that you see with floppy things around, you can actually get that using a flounce. So that is just how to cut a flounce basically. If there's any question, drop it in the comment section. You can also reach us on the Facebook, on Instagram. We'll drop it on the screen. You can chat with us on the number going on your screen. We have a physical fashion class that runs in Ibadan, Nigeria. You can make inquiries on how to join a staff if you want to learn fashion designing in the proper way. If you cannot come to Ibadan, we have the online class that runs from time to time, basic, intermediate, and advanced online class. You can also make inquiries on joining that class. So any other thing that you need, please drop it on in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and we hope to be back with something else other than films. Thank you.